हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम्स ऑल ऑफ यू टू दिस लेक्चर. सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड यूनिट नंबर टू, दैट इज़ अ डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम. एंड यूनिट नंबर वन वी हैव कवर्ड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रांसड्यूसर्स. ओके, सो ट्रांसड्यूसर पार्ट एंड डेटा एक्विजिशन वी हैव कवर्ड. अंडर ट्रांसड्यूसर्स वी हैव सीन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रांसड्यूसर्स लाइक टेम्परेचर, डिस्प्लेसमेंट. Okay, so after that we have seen a data acquisition system. Under that, signal conditioning that we have seen, and most important part inside that signal conditioning was the analog to digital converters and digital to analog converters that we have seen. Okay, now if you see our subject name, that is a subject name that is measurement and instrumentations. Okay, so we have to study thoroughly what do we mean by measurement and what do we mean by instrumentation, and different types of instruments we have to study. Okay, so till now we have seen only basic things like transducers and data acquisition. Now onwards we have to see what do you mean by measurements, why measurement is important, and we have to see different types of instruments after that. Okay, so this is unit number 3 that we have to start today, that is a measurement systems and measuring instruments. Okay, so let us see the basics of a measurement in this unit. So what do we mean by measurement? Basically that we have to study first, and why the measurement is important. Okay, so the definition of a measurement is like this. The measurement of a given quantity is the act or a result of a quantitative comparison between an unknown quantity and predefined standard quantity. Okay, so it is actually the quantitative comparison between your quantity that is to be measured and the predefined standard quantity. We have to compare these two quantities. Okay, so why the measurement is required? Because we must know the quantity that we are handling in our data processing or in our system. Okay, so we must know the standard quantity of that, so that we can evaluate the performance of our systems, and so that we can take a further decision to process that quantity and to control different things. Okay, so the measurement is most important thing inside this any data acquisition system, or we can say physical systems. Everything starts from a measurement only. Okay, so that's why measurement is very important. So see again the definition of this. The measurement of the given quantity is the act or the result of quantitative comparison between unknown quantity and predefined standard quantities. So there are different standards and units are available. Okay, that we know, like a meter, centimeter, kilogram. Okay, so these are the some standard quantities, standard units are there, and with the help of the standard units we have to measure unknown quantity. Okay, so this process is nothing but the measurement. But the measurement is not restricted to this only. This is vast area that we will see in upcoming slides. Okay, so generally metrology is the name given to the science of a pure measurement. So if you see the science of a pure measurement in a physics, if you see the metrology, this name is given to the science of a pure measurement. Okay, but if you see the engineering branch or engineering world, this engineering measurement or metrology is restricted to measurement of lengths and angles only. Okay, so no doubt we are measuring different parameters, different signals, but mostly we are going to measure length or angle. Okay, so sometime we are measuring different parameters of liquids also, okay, and solids also, but the length and angle, these are the mostly measured in engineering field. Okay, so measurement is defined as the process of a numerical evaluation of a dimensions, or the process of a comparison with a standard measuring instruments. Okay, so it is again the process of a numerical evaluation of a dimension of a given quantity or given substance, or it is the process of a comparison with a standard measuring instrument that we have already discussed. Okay, now why measure things, why to do measurement? Okay, so to check the quality or to check the tolerance. Okay, so this is not restricted to only quality or tolerance on. Okay, so there are number of parameters which are taken into account while doing a measurements, or the measurements depends upon different parameters. Our measurement leads to evaluation of a different parameters that we have to see. So the why to measure the things, why to measure the things means what? No doubt we have to check the quality of our instrument, or we have to check the quality of our system's output. Then no doubt we have to see that if there is any tolerance in between the standard quantity and your produced output. But there are again another applications of this measurement or use of this measurement. Okay, so what is the need of this measurement that we have to see now? So need of a measurement. Okay, so the first one is to establish a standard. Okay, so universally, if you see, there are different types of units are available and standards are available, and they are universal. Okay, so to establish some standard, with that standard units and quantity, we have to do some measurements. Okay, so you have to show your results in terms of that universal units and standards. So to establish the standard, need to measure the different things, or there is a need of a measurement. Next one is interchangeability. Okay, so yes, of course, interchangeability is possible only when you do the measurement with respect to standard quantities. Okay, suppose if you want to convert your measured value into a standard value, like a centimeter to meter or millimeter to meter, okay, or gram to kilogram, then such interchangeability will be only possible when you do the perfect measurement with some standard quantities. So for the interchangeability also, the measurement is required, and you have to keep in mind is that this measurement should be done with respect to some standard units and some standards that we have to see afterwards. Then customer satisfaction. Okay, so suppose you design one system, and suppose that system is given some output, then you have to measure that output, and you have to show to that customer that this much output I am getting. But how much you are getting that output, that at that time you have to measure that particular quantity, and you have to compare with that standard quantity, and you have to show the results. So for the customer satisfaction also, the measurement is required. The next is validate the design. Of course, we are using the standard units for measurement, then validation is very important. Then we come to know that different physical parameters available in our systems. So that's why again the measurements are required. So we get true dimensions when you measure with perfect standards. And last one is very important, that is to evaluate the performance. Okay, suppose you have designed one system, and if you want to check the system is giving you a proper output or not. So how to check that your system's output? Then you have to compare your system's output with some standard values or some units. So the measurements also helps you, or we can say that this is our motto, that is to evaluate the performance of our system or your instrument, that is the with the help of measurements. Okay, so these are some parameters which are required or taken into consideration for the measurement. Okay, so these are some needs of measurements that we have seen. So let us see the methods of measurements. There are n number of methods which are available while doing the measurements, but we have to see some of them. Okay, so which are generally used. The first one is direct method, the second one is indirect, then comparative method is there, then contact or contactless method is there, then deflection method is there, and then complementary method is also there. Okay, so these are some methods which are available for the measurement. Again, I am repeating, there are n number of methods which are available. You can search on internet, you can search in books, but these are some standard methods of measurement that are generally used for measurements. So as an engineer, you must know how these methods are utilized for measuring any quantity or system's output. Okay, so in short, we have to see these methods one by one. Okay, so let us see direct method of measurement. So generally, if you see this direct and indirect method, these are two very famous methods of measurement. Okay, so first let us see this direct method of measurement. So this is a simple method of a measurement in which the value of the quantity to be measured is obtained directly without any calculation. Okay, so means what? For example, measuring by using scales like vernier calipers, micrometers, so bevel protractor, like this. Okay, so this method is widely used in production. This method is not very accurate because it depends on human insensitivity or sensitiveness in making a judgment. Okay, so this is the direct method where the physical contact of human is there. Why we are calling this as a physical contact of human is there? Because this type of a measurement is done with the help of some scales. Now suppose you are measuring height of or height of or width of any object with the help of a scale. So it will give you the value in terms of directly centimeter or meter, or based upon the type of scale that you are used. So such a method is called as a direct method. Okay, so that's why it is given here that the value of the quantity to be measured is obtained directly without any calculation. There is no need to do any calculation. The that scale or that method directly it is showing you the value or displaying you the value. So there is no need to do any complex mathematics. Okay, so that's why this method is called as a direct method. But as discussed now, this method is not wisely used because it is not very accurate, because it depends upon human sensitivity. Okay, why? Because if the human is suppose you are measuring height or width of any object, and at that time suppose you are making some error, then that error will be also introduced in your output. Okay, so that's why you have to correctly measure that particular width or height or value. So its accuracy totally depends upon how you are going to use that particular instrument while measurements. Okay, so if you see the example that we have discussed earlier, that is scales and vernier calipers. So measurement are directly obtained like this. It is shown here. So it is a scale, and with the help of this scale you are getting the direct value of a measurement. Okay, so this we have seen direct method, which are very which is very simple method of a measurement. Then indirect method. So in indirect method, the value of a quantity to be measured is obtained by the measuring other quantities which are functionally related to the required value. So suppose here in this case direct method, you are directly getting the height, width of any object if you are using a scales. But in indirect method, the output quantity is depend upon different types of parameters. So we have to calculate that parameters, and after doing some calculations you are getting the that actual value. So that's why it is called as an indirect method. Okay, so directly here also directly we are getting some values, but why it is called as indirect? Because we have to do some calculations after that. So that's why it is called as an indirect method of a measurement. So for example, if you see this is one block. Okay, so if you want to measure the weight of this block, so the weight of this block depends upon what? Its length, its width or breadth, then its height, and after that the most important parameter is that it's a density. Okay, so density depends upon different parameters that you know, the material you have used here. The density depends upon that material. Okay, so here I have taken one small example. You can consider this material any type of a material, but I want to tell you that it is obtained by measuring other quantities. Means what? The weight is our goal, but the weight is directly not measured here. We have to measure the length, we have to measure the breadth, we have to measure the height, then we have to see the density of the material that we have used in this block, and after that by multiplying these all quantities we are getting the weight of this particular object. Okay, so that's why this method is called as an indirect method. Okay, so this is all about the indirect method. Now we have to see the next type of a method, that is comparative type of a method. So in this method, the value of the quantity to be measured is compared with known value of the same quantity. Okay, means what? See here, suppose let me explain this again. In this method, the value of the quantity to be measured is compared with known value of the same quantity or the other quantity practically related to it. Means what? We have to compare that value with some standard value, okay, and after that we are getting the output. Okay, so for example, dial indicators or other comparators. Okay, so in this method only the deviation from the master gauge are determined, that is dial indicators, and different types of comparators are there. Okay, so for example, it is compared with the known other value. Okay, so here one is known other value or known value, and one is the value is to be compared. Okay, so one is showing value is to be compared, and one is showing the some standard value. Okay, so like this the comparative method is utilized. So in short, you have to compare with some other value of the same quantity. So like this the comparative method is utilized. Then a very simple method, that is contact method. So here sensor or measuring tip touch the surface area. Okay, so if it is not touching the surface area to be measured, then it is called as contactless method. And then you can add here another method, that is contactless method. So the sensors or measuring tips which touch the surface area, then that is called as a contact method. Okay, so this is all about the contact method. It's very simple. The next one is complementary method. So in this method, the value of the quantity to be measured is combined with a known value of the same quantity. Okay, so the combination is so adjusted that the sum of these two value is equal to predefined comparison value. So what do you meaning of this? If you take the example, we can determine the value of a volume of a solid by liquid displacement. For example, suppose here the value of the quantity to be measured is combined with the known value of the same quantity. Okay, so if you see this example, this is a volume determined by the liquid displacement. Okay, so if you see here, some object is placed here, and due to that the liquid displacement is there. Okay, so if you have to calculate this liquid displacement, and that will give you the what we can say, the area or the density. Actual density means what? The again, the density, if you see here, sometimes density matters, sometimes density does not matter. Okay, so that we will see afterwards in detail. But if you see here, take consideration into the area only. This area, based upon this area, the displacement will be there. Okay, so in this method, again I am repeating, in this method the value of the quantity to be measured is combined with known value of the same quantity. Okay, so here due to that solid object, some liquid displacement is there, and this, if you see here, it is 30 and here it is a 40. Okay, now here it is increased by 10 units, so we can directly relate with this object. But there is need to do some calculations related to this, because though it is proportional, then some quantities or some parameters need to be measured. So density parameter is again important here, but don't consider density parameter here, just see the area only. Okay, so the next is deflection type of method. Okay, the value to be measured is directly indicated by a deflection of a pointer. Okay, so I think you may have seen speedometer, or different speedometer, that is analog speedometer. So the value to be measured is directly indicated with the help of some pointer. Okay, so if you see that old bikes or old speedometer of that old bikes, then that speed is directly deflected by the pointer. Okay, suppose you are running your bike on 50 kilometer per hour speed, then it will show on that deflection, that is 50 kilometer per hour, and it is deflecting with respect to your speed, that is proportional to your speed. Okay, so such type of method is called as a deflection method. Generally these are the analog types of measuring methods. Okay, so mechanical arrangement is done inside, so your rotational speed is converted into, or your speed of your bike is converted into some mechanical moment which are deflected on that meter. Okay, so for example, pressure measurement we can say, and then there may be a speed measurement. Okay, so these are also important, because today also some of the industries are using this deflection type of pointer. Okay, But nowadays, these are replaced with some digital displays which are giving some character value. Okay, so if you compare with that digital display and this deflection type of displays, then the digital displays are giving you accurate values. Okay, very small variation it is also showing on that display. But in case of this deflection type of method, it is not possible to show very small deflection. And even if there is a deflection, there may be some delay in actual quantity and that deflection, because some mechanical arrangement that we have done or we have to do inside this. And when that mechanical arrangement fails to operate inside, then this may show you error or some aging effect will be there. Okay, so that's why the maintenance is required in this case of a deflection type of method. So that's why nowadays digital types of displays are available, and these digital displays value can be also stored if you want the storage for a future values or evaluation of your systems. Okay, so that's why this deflection type of method is not mostly used in industries or in any systems. Okay, but somewhere it is also used nowadays also. Okay, so this is all about the types of methods that we have studied. That is a direct, then indirect, then comparative method, then contact method, then deflection method, and the complementary method. Okay, so these are some important methods of measurements. Okay, so while explaining these methods of measurement, if you draw a small diagram, then it will be better for you, okay, to fetch more marks. Now let us see some units and standards. Okay, so why we have to see these units and standards? Because without units and without considering some standards, it is not possible to measure any quantity. Okay, so that's why worldwide there are some units which are declared by different committees, and these are used for measurements of any quantity. Okay, so based upon the measurement, there are different units are available. Okay, so you may know different types of MKG and CGS standards or methods of measurements. Okay, so I think you have studied that, but some of the standards or units need to be revised here, because as this is a measurement subject, you must know that units. Okay, so that's why let's take a look on this, the units. Okay, so SI units are there, which are the fundamental units. So what do you mean by SI? System internationally, that is called as, or system international, that is SI, fundamental of units. Then physical quantity, unit name and symbol is given here, which you may know already, but let us see again, because this is very important as far as the measurement and instrumentation subject is concerned. If you see the length is given in a meter and the symbol is M. Then mass is measured with the help of kilogram, unit name is kilogram, and given by the symbol kg. Time, which is given in seconds, and it is yes. So please keep one important thing is that I am talking only SI units now. Okay, so electric current, ampere, given by the A. Temperature, Kelvin, it is given by K. Then amount of substance, that is calculated with the help of mole, and the symbol is MOL. Luminous intensity is given by the candela, okay, and the symbol is CD. Okay, there are some derived units, SI derived units are there, which are derived from this fundamental units. Let us have a look on this. So area is given by the square meter, that is M square, symbol is M square. Volume is given by cubic meter, that is meter cube. Speed is given by meter per second, that is M by S. Okay, acceleration is meter per second square. Okay, so please keep in your mind the speed is different and acceleration is different. Okay, so acceleration is given by meter per second square, that is very important. So if you see weight or a force, it is given by the Newton, the symbol is capital N. Then if you see the pressure, it is given by the Pascal, the unit is Pa. Then energy or work is given by joule, and the symbol is J. Okay, and there are some supplementary units are also available For example, if you take a plane angle as a physical quantity, which is measured in a radian, and the symbol is RAD. Okay, and suppose the solid angle is there, the steroid is there, and given by the SR. Okay, now these are some important quantities or units are represented here. I have represented this, but there are n number of units. Fundamental units are there, derived units are there, and supplement units are there, which are used in engineering. So that you have to refer in books, and you have to study that, because I think this is very basic part, and you may have studied in your engineering or physics earlier. Okay, so I am not giving so much time for this, that is for units. So this much is sufficient for this lecture, because in second unit, in the next lecture, we have to start with some standards, and we will see different system characteristics afterwards. Okay, so I request you to just take a pen and paper, and please note down all the fundamental units, derived units, and the supplementary units, rather than this also that I have added in this slide on a paper, so that it will be very better for you, because interconversion is again very important. You must know how to convert the meter into centimeter or millimeter, then gram into kilogram, then seconds into we can say minutes, hours. Okay, so temperature into Kelvin, so that is also very important. Then temperature Kelvin into temperature degree Celsius, Fahrenheit, that is again very important, because these are different standards are available and units are available there, and interconversion is again very important. So that is your part that you have to cover. Okay, because as a measurement engineer, you must know all these things. Okay, so this much we have covered for this lecture, and hope you understood this, you all have understood this. Okay, so just revise this lecture again, what we have seen, what is the need of a measurement, what is the definition, so why to do the measurements, that is also again important, methods are also again important. Then if you want to refer on internet, you can refer, and just you can add number of methods which are available, because this subject is pure theoretical. Okay, so it is not possible to cover each and every point in this small lectures. Okay, so that's why again, if you want to want extra information, you can refer a books or refer internet. So much resources are available on internet, you can get so much information there, and you can prepare your own notes. Okay, so this much we have seen now, my methods, comparative methods, then different types of deflection methods, and all this. So we have seen units, and in next lecture we'll start with some standards. Okay, so this much is sufficient for today's lecture, just to go through the lecture. Okay, and keep one important thing is that these lectures I have recorded, and I am playing the recording at the time of a lecture, and after the lecture I am giving you time, because you have to make your own notes, or you have to clear some doubts which I have earlier explained. Okay, because this is a one way lecture, that the recording, when I play the recording, it is a one way lecture only. Okay, so there is no any interaction with you. Okay, so that's why I'm giving you some time after the lecture, so that you can revise these concepts, you can revisit the points you have not understood while playing the video, and you can make notes afterwards. So that's why I'm giving you time. This you have to keep in mind. Okay, so I think you got this, please prepare very well, and I think this unit is very small, we will complete soon that. Okay, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, thank you very much. So let us stop here. Just see, again I'm repeating, just see these fundamental units which you are going to use in throughout your life. Okay, it is not restricted to only measurements and instrumentation. Okay, so please note more number of units, fundamental units. Please see what is MKG, what is CGS standard. Okay, what is the difference between that? Make a chart of that. Okay, that is very important. So let us stop here with this. Okay, if you have any query, you can ask me. Okay, so thank you very much. Let us meet in the next lecture. Okay, so stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself and your family members. We are going to stop here. Thank you. Thank you very much.